begun. Many of us are trying to get back to a healthier diet that doesn't include all the indulgences that come with eating holiday snacks and cookies and cakes and everything else that I ate. But snacking smart doesn't have to mean being bland and boring. And here to show us some healthy and tasty snacks that'll satisfy our munchies, please welcome back chef and entertaining expert Heather Christo.
Hi.
Thanks for coming back, Heather.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. I'm up a few pounds from the holidays, I gotta admit.
I can't even talk about it.
I know, right? So this is a perfect segment for us.
This is the perfect way to get back on track by slowly working in healthy snacks. It's gonna, kind of bring you back from the dark side.
Right,
That's my theory, right?
Okay, all right, so bring us back from the dark side. What are we starting with?
The first recipe I'm gonna show you is a fresh salmon ceviche. And I like to just get a good, really fresh piece of salmon. And you want to cube it up. And do you meanwhile want to put in the cucumber in that bowl?
Just go for it.
Just go for it.
Okay.
I'm not making you touch the salmon, so the cucumber should be good.
Okay.
And you want to get sashimi grade salmon, like something that's okay to eat raw, like
right.
a good quality salmon. Oh, that was good. I guess I'll be touching the salmon. So you want to put this in here.
Okay.
And while it's raw, we're going to pour lime juice on it, which will help the cooking process.
This guy?
Oh no, not yet. That one's sesame oil. Let me get this out of the way.
You can see I really know my way around the kitchen.
Stick it in the oven.
That's not the lime juice, that's the sesame oil.
That's okay. And we're gonna add mango also. And a great tip is if you take a large spoon and a half of a mango, and you can just kind of run it underneath the mango along the skin.
Okay.
And it should just pop out. Otherwise, it can be kind of hard to get the mango out.
Okay.
And you want to dice it. And the mango has a nice, bright, fruity flavor that will complement the salmon really well.
Okay.
And another ingredient we're going to add is the scallions over here,
okay.
the green onions, if you want to dump
those in.
Yeah.
It is so almost too pretty to eat
it
at this point.
It is pretty. All the colors. You eat with your eyes first, right?
Right.
Here's another tip. If you just take a half of an avocado, and you gently watch your fingers score it. That's not
that
funny. And take the same spoon, and you can just scoop it out and into here. You don't have to
that
use
is
the
so
whole
much
thing.
Easier
so
than
much
what
easier.
I do. Yeah.
And then some fresh cilantro.
Okay. Now this looks gorgeous, but is this the kind of thing that you can get your kids to eat? You have two kids, yeah?
I do, a two and a 4-year
kids,
old, and I'll be honest, I'm not sure if I could get them to eat the salmon ceviche, but I do have some other healthy snacks here.
Okay.
I added some lime zest and some fresh lime juice, which is gonna cook the ceviche with its acid, cook the raw fish, and then just some kosher salt, some black sesame seeds, and some sesame oil.
You mean lime juice. That was my really bad check.
That's right, exactly.
Okay.
And when you stir it all up, you're gonna have a beautiful ceviche that
looks
like that.
Yeah, that looks gorgeous.
That.
And so you were saying that the acid kind of cooks it. Do you want it to sit for any amount of time before you eat it?
You could for sure let it sit, for a couple of hours.
Okay.
But it's fine just to eat right now. And this is great not only if you're kind of treating yourself to a beautiful lunch, like a mini meal, or an afternoon snack, or great for a party.
Okay,
yeah,
that's great.
And on some toasted rice crackers so you don't add a bunch of calories.
Which is, top of mind at this point.
Yes, right. And then over here we've got something I call avocado toast, and I'll just scoop out an avocado on a cutting board, sprinkle it with salt and lemon, and smash it up with a fork. And then at the end, I put it on some whole grain toast, add a little olive oil, and it's a great snack.
That
and you can make
good.
A big batch of that in the morning and leave the pit in so that it doesn't turn brown. You've got fresh.
So that's the key.
Yes.
Refrigerate or no?
If you refrigerate it.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay.
And just stick that pit in there.
Okay.
And here's one that's kind of kid friendly. We've got a smoky chickpea dip, and I use beet chips, baked beet chips or cucumbers, but kids kind of like to dip anything.
Yeah.
And then here's the ultimate healthy snack. It feels so indulgent and so delicious, but it's low in calories, high in protein, fiber, very nutritious. Greek yogurt, which is like so thick and luxurious.
It is so
right?
good.
It's almost like whipping cream.
Yeah.
Without all of the horrible fat. And then I've got some homemade granola in there, but just a little bit, just for crunch, texture, flavor, and then fresh berries.
So how do you make granola at home. This is probably way easier than it sounds, but to me, that's the kind of thing where I'm like, I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Yeah,
with
you
like
just
this.
Oats. Okay. I do oats. I do dried cranberries or coconut, tiny bit of oil and some honey, toss it all together and bake it. And I've got tons of homemade granola recipes on my website.
And these are the types of things that you feel like you don't have, the people who are watching who are not chefs like you can do this.
All
no
of it's super easy. I always think, especially not to leave the gentleman out, but when you're a mom or a working woman, if it's not easy, you're not going to do it.
Right.
So everything's super easy.
And the beet chips, did you do those yourself too?
You can just bake them. You just thinly slice beets.
Okay.
You could do it with a lot of different vegetables, sweet potatoes. You want to coat them with, kind of brush them with olive oil, and you just bake them at 350 for about 40 minutes.
And so how much time would you allow if you were going to introduce, because you said, you know, we got to take it slow. We detox a little slowly after the holidays. So like one of these meals a day for a week, and then you're back on track?
Oh my gosh, I wish. For each person, it's different. But.
And so you think this is good for the kids, and this is good for
everybody. Yeah, I mean, also this one, you know, my kids love guacamole, and this is essentially a guacamole.
Can you have them come over and talk to my kids about guacamole?
Yes.
I'd like if they like that.
Yes, no problem.
Heather, thank you so much.
Thank
Heather
you.
Has, like she said, lots of great ideas for cooking and entertaining at home on her website. We'll have a link to it over on our website. When we come back, fitness trainer Rachel Elizabeth Murray shows us how we can fire up our workout routine and burn calories around the clock despite the chilly weather. Stay with us.